It's my cell phone. I carry it with me 24 hours a day.
Imagine meeting someone over broccoli.
I know, what are the odds? Excuse me. My associate's applying dairy foods to his body. Call me? Fraser, what are you doing?
It's 19 degrees cooler over here.
I know you're nostalgic for that glacier lifestyle, but you're missing the whole point of coming to a supermarket.
What do you mean?
Well, the modern supermarket is the place to meet women in the 90s.
Really?
Absolutely. I mean, you don't know who you're going to meet in a bar. At least in here, you can tell a lot about a person just by the section you meet her in.
How?
Well, for example, if she's near the vegetables, she cares about a body. If she's near the meat, an animal in bed. And if she's near the Eskimo pies, she's given up, moved back to meat. Oh, no, you're putting beef on your nose? Stop that.
This meat is bad.
Well, that's a shame because it looks really good on you. Why don't you dab a little pork behind your ears?
So is this one.
Please hurry, my boy is sick. He's in danger. Please hurry.
Going as fast as I can, lady.
Mi hijo, su estómago tiene fiebre.
That's nice. You know how much this was?
No.
I need a price check on five. Price check on five.
Just forget that one.
Hey, this isn't enough.
Will that cover it?
Mom. Mom.
He's burning up. He's so hot.
He's getting worse. Con la bomba.
They're on their way.
Kid?
They pumped his stomach. I think they got to him soon enough. He should be okay.
Good. Because I have a feeling I'm going to have to rush off here on some urgent business. Hello, Miss Broccoli. Ma, what are you calling me on my private line for? Of course I got the Parmesan.
Ms. Gomez.
Yes?
All right, there should be no permanent damage.
Oh, thank you, Doctor. Thank you.
Bob, Elliot just made the Chicago All-Stars in soccer.
Great.
Now, we may never know exactly what caused this, but it looks like food poisoning. Probably you left some meat out too long.
No, that's not possible. I would never do that.
I'm here. Are you Mrs. Gomez?
Yes.
Can we use your office?
Don't be too long.
What did you mean?
Well, I had to call Child and Family Services. They just want to talk to you about a few things, all right?
Hey, little guy scored 3 goals in the first period.
This way.
Excuse me, doctor. I'm Constable Benton Fraser, Royal Canadian Mounted Police.
Oh, what's your connection here, Constable?
I'm just trying to lend a hand, sir.
He does that a lot.
I think you're right about it being food poisoning, sir, but not from food that's been left out too long. I believe the little boy ate diseased meat.
And why do you believe that?
Olfactory analysis.
You smelled it?
He does that a lot, too.
I took this from the trash in Mrs. Gammes' apartment, and I thought perhaps you could.
There's not enough there to analyze. Constable, I appreciate your concern, but, frankly, I think we're dealing here with a woman from South America who's used to a different level of hygiene. I had no choice but to make the call to protect both the children and the hospital.
El Salvador.
What?
They're from El Salvador.
I'm sure they are.
What are you doing?
Checking to see if he has any outstanding parking tickets.
I noticed that our office has been in contact with you before, Mrs. Gammes.
That's right.
Three complaints by a Mr. Tagister.
The landlord? He's trying to get us to move so he can rent my apartment for more money.
And you have three other children? Mr. Gammes is not in the house?
No.
You must have your hands full. I just have two kids and they make my head spin.
My eldest daughter helps me. She's a very good girl.
Well, it's certainly understandable that a mistake can be made.
I didn't make a mistake.
Your refrigerator's broken?
Mr. Tagister won't fix it.
You do understand, Mrs. Gammes, that if you don't keep meat cold...
I only buy enough to use each day.
Why do you think your other kids didn't get sick?
They ate at the neighbors.
What do they have?
I don't really know.
Okay. That should do it for now.
What do you mean for now?
Thank you for helping me.
You're welcome.
I bet you've never seen a real detective's badge up close.
This hat is so cool.
How about a taser?
What is it?
It make it that I hurt my Mario. That I make it sick.
Ray?
Yeah, I gotta get back to the office. Welsh has been all over me. All right. I know somebody who knows somebody. We'll get the food inspector on it right away.
I promise you, ma'am, nothing bad will happen.
Bless you.
Look, you can reach me or the world's nicest person through this number.
See you soon, Mario.
This is ridiculous. I've got 12 stores. Never had any complaints about my meat.
He's right. All of this meat is healthy.
Are you sure? My friend's nose has been in some strange places, but he's never been wrong.
I'm quite sure.
He's right. This meat is okay. It's also been changed.
Enough evidence for a warrant.
We don't need one. 100 pounds of ground meat does not just enter a supermarket and then leave without a trace. Ah, yes.
Oh, no.
You know, Fraser, when I was a little boy, I used to dream of what it would be like to be a police officer. You know, shooting a bad guy, saving a girl, being knee-deep in day-old chicken heads, looking for tainted meat was never a part of that dream.
Check that container there.
Why? If they wanted to hide something, they just wouldn't have dumped it in here.
Well, perhaps not this time. But garbage has a history, Ray. It always leaves something behind.
Yeah, and most of it seems to be on me. You know what really annoys me? Why am I covered in crud, and you look like you just got back from a hand laundry?
I don't know. I've always been this way.
Ciao, it's Raimondo.
Ma! No, Ma, I did not forget the lettuce, okay? I got it right here. You see a head of lettuce anywhere? Ma, no. Yes, I got. Look. No, I gotta go. Fraser's picking lint off me again. All right, bye. Thanks, but I don't think it's gonna help.
It might.
What is it?
Parasites.
Those were on me?
Yes. Ray?
These things wash off, right?
Parasites? Yes, of course.
Although there's always a chance that they laid eggs.
More so! Give me more so!
But I don't think so. Most parasites live only on particular hosts.
What? I wasn't gracious enough. I should have offered them canapés.
No, no. What I mean is that they're,
Oh, I hope you like spaghetti and meatballs.
Well, if you made it, Mrs. Vecchio, I'm sure it will be delicious.
Ma, you want to get out of the bathroom?
He's such a baby.
It's because I'm wet!
What I mean is that each type of animal has its own distinct parasite.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know you were in here.
Didn't know.
She's been standing in the doorway, timing it so you'd be undressed.
You are such a liar.
I am naked in here. Does that mean anything to anybody?
Shut up!
Here, you can use my towels.
Well, thank you, but I'm afraid I'm not having a shower.
Oh, don't be silly. It's really no trouble.
And don't use all the hot water.
I'll wait for mine.
Yeah, by the keyhole. You know, I've really had enough of your mouth.
I could be wrong, Ray, but I've never seen this parasite in beef. Or pork, for that matter. I have a question for you.
Hey, man! Shut that off!
What are you gonna do to become a monkey?
Well, Tony, there's a whole battery of mental and physical tests you have to pass.
I can do that.
You can't turn on the big screen without getting winded.
Who are you, Jane Fonda?
In fact, Ray, the only animal I've ever seen this on... It was horse meat, Ray.
I don't know. These meatballs don't seem quite right. I don't know if it's the oregano or the garlic. What's missing?
Beef.
Ma, where'd you buy the meat?
Pettit's Food Town. I think I know what's wrong.
No, 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 Ma, don't insult food. Dog food.
Possibly diseased.
Move out of my way! No, no, Ma, that was evidence.
What am I gonna do for dinner? I'm about to let you go, Ma.
I'm afraid I was too late to get a specimen.
You know, this meat could be everywhere.
Hi, it's Vecchio.
Yes, Mrs. Gomez, he's right here.
Hello, Miss... We'll be right there.
We'll be right where? I can't go like this.
Stop them, please, stop them.
Excuse me, why is this happening?
We did a surprise inspection. There's no hot water.
The landlord won't fix the heater.
There's evidence of vermin.
I beg him to call the exterminator. Please don't take my children.
Mrs. Gomez, your boy could have died from that meat.
Well, I may be able to shed some light on that.
Frankly, we believe her children will be safer under our umbrella right now. I'm sorry.
You promised you would help me. You didn't.
No, I understand that. Yeah, well, she should at least be able to see her kids. Right? All right, well, how long will you be considering this?
Yeah, well, thanks. Have a great day, too.
Hey, hey! Your deaf wolf just ate my jelly donut.
He doesn't like donuts.
Yeah, well, maybe not yours. Come here. I know you did it.
Vecchio. How you doing on a drugstore homicide on Pulaski?
Well, sir, you see, I'm putting together the preliminary findings, and I've been combing over them, and I'm looking for that telltale thread that's going to give up the shooter.
So I can assume you haven't done anything?
That would be accurate, sir, but something has come up.
Louis.
Louis, sir.
You get the Pulaski case.
Yes, sir.
Oh, come on, sir. You see, I'm working on this thing. It's sort of a, how can I put it, sir? Somebody is switching dog food for beef.
Dog food, Vecchio? I assigned you to a dog food case?
Oh, no, sir, but I believe I have a situation happening here, sir.
Drop it.
Yes, sir.
Dog food?
Jack, why is it that you and I never come up with great cases like that?
I don't know, Louis. I guess we just don't have the nose for it.
Or perhaps we don't stay low enough in the ground to sniff it out.
Perhaps.
Come on, fellas, give yourself a little more credit than that. You're plenty low enough.
Is that right, Vecchio?
Yeah, I mean, sure. How else can you get your noses that lovely shade of brown?
Maybe you and I should get together after work.
I don't think so, Louis. I got dinner plans.
Forget it, Louis. Come on.
You see, this is why... Hello? This is why I don't like to help you, because I get humiliated.
Well, I'm very sorry about that, Ray.
I'm a police detective. I don't know from horses, all right? Give me pimps. Give me drug dealers. Give me something I know how to find.
As you're asking about horses, I did some checking, and there's a major auction going on today at the ground south of Arlington. I thought you'd want
to. Thank you very much, Elaine.
And what is it do we have to go on? One little lousy bug? Has it ever occurred to you that you could be wrong?
You were right, Fraser. I have never seen this particular strain before, but it is definitely a kind of Onchocercus cervicalis, and it's found only in horse meat.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Madison.
Sure.
If something tells me that we're on to something, I'm not going to let him take this away from me.
A moment of your time, please, sir.
Forget it.
Thank you, sir.
Excuse me, sir. Detective Vecchio believes that we have the potential for a major health crisis here, and there appears to be a strong indication of criminal intent.
You really believe that?
Yes, I do, sir.
Good. Go tell the FDA.
Is that a meatloaf sandwich, sir?
Yes, it is. Why?
Oh, well, no reason, sir. I was just wondering, does your wife shop at Pettit's Food Town?
All right. Get on it.
Thank you very much, sir.
Nicely done.
Same to you.
Are you going to check for priors on the supermarket owner?
On my way.
I'll be at the auction. Call me if you find anything.
Okay.
Excuse me. Stand to one side. Just scared.
Thanks.
No problem.
Nice work. Just made it a whole lot easier for them to kill that beautiful horse. Stop the slaughter. Save the horses. Stop the slaughter. Save the horses. Thank you. Stop the slaughter. Save the horses. Stop the slaughter. Save the horses.
Excuse me. There's nothing wrong with that horse.
There's nothing wrong with half the horses they're auctioning. They're still going to be dog food by the weekend. Stop the slaughter, save the horses, thank you. Stop the slaughter, save the horses, thank you.
You've got quite some printing budget here, Miss Gabbett.
Obviously not enough to stop butchers like you.
Oh, well, then allow me to contribute.
I don't want your blood money.
How you do overreact. I am a businessman, Miss Gabbett, and I provide a useful service.
You also grind up people's pets and use them for filler.
I'm the buyer, not the seller. You might save some of that righteous indignation for the seller.
Yes, well, believe me, I do.
Mm-hmm. You know what she needs, don't you? Mm-hmm.
Oh, yes. A world where people don't value life by the pound.
What?
Excuse me.
The auction is starting, folks. Let's settle in. First horse weighs in at 788 pounds. The bidding starts at 50 and 5, 55, how about 55, how about 55, how about 55, 55 and 7, 7, how about 60, and 2, 10, 81, 2 and 5, how about 65 there and 7, 67 there now, 70, 70 now and 2, 10, 2, 3, and 73 cents, and 4, 4, 5, and 75, and 6, and 7, 7, 7, how about 8, 8, 9, 9, how about 80, 80, how about 1, 80 there now, 1, 81 and 2, 10, 81, 2, sold, 81 cents, Miss Cabot. This horse weighs 1180. All righty, how much, folks? How about a 50? Now 5. How about a 55? How about a 52? 5. How about a 55? 7. 7.
You got a problem with something?
You ought to move your foot.
Maybe I don't want to move my foot.
But if you don't move your foot, I can't get to that horse, Patty.
Why would you want that horse, Patty?
I'm not telling.
Tell me why you want that horse, Patty, and maybe I'll move my foot.
Never.
I'm a cop.
So what?
Do you want to serve time over a piece of manure?
I'd rather go to the chair than talk.
You know what I just decided? I've just decided that you are so nuts, I'm gonna let you have that, Patty.
Yo, Sergeant Preston!
Yo, Sergeant Preston, I bring news from the trading post. Turns out our supermarket owner doesn't have a record. He's squeaky clean.
I see.
He has a chain of stores, but they're barely breaking even. However, he did just buy a home for $1 million cash. Oh, and Santa Lab guy wanted me to tell you that buggy took off me only infects...
Wild horses?
Very good.
I was afraid of that.
Our next horse weighs in at 990 pounds.
Is that what these are?
No, wild horses would have a different angle of the foot. The hoof would grow out. It'd be chipped on the outside.
Naturally.
Also, wild horses are protected. You can't capture them or sell them.
So what happened? One just crawled into the dumpster and passed away?
I don't know, Ray. But it would appear we're not going to find the answer here.
Great. I'll get the car. You say goodbye to the babe.
Babe? Oh. You mean...
Yeah.
Well, there's nothing between us.
I'm sure.
I barely know her.
This horse weighs in at 975 pounds. All right, bidding starts. 70, thank you. Now, two. Here, what are they
going to
get to?
Isn't that...
Yes, it is.
75, set to pound. 75, now 77. Bad 77, now 80. How are they at 80? Now 1, 81 and 2. Bad 82, what are they going to get? 2, 3, what are they going to get? 3, 4. Bad 84 cents here. 84 and 5. How are they going to get? 5, 6. 6 here, 7, down 8. 88 cents and 9. 89, now 90. Now, how are they at 90? Now, how are they at 90? Now, how are they? Thank you, sir. 95. All bids in at 95 cents. 95, all bids in.
97.
I'm sorry, Miss Cabot, but you're over your credit limit.
I'm out of money.
I'm at 95 cents. Any further advance at 95?
Take my car!
I'm sorry, Miss Cabot, but the terms are cash. 95 cents. All through it down at 95.
I have 30.
Sold. Leg of meats. 95 cents a pound.
Damn it.
Miss Cabot, do you mind if I ask you how you can afford to...
Out of my allowance.
Oh, I see. So then you'd be quite,
Actually,
quite...
it's my father who's quite... Fortunately, he approves of how I'm spending the money.
And, now you'd be going to...
To sell my car. It was nice meeting you.
Excuse me, I was wondering if, before you leave... Could I ask you a question?
Yes?
Would it be possible for you to get me a breakdown of the various meat packers and number of horses that bought out?
You know, that is the most unique come-on I've ever heard.
I don't follow you.
I'll, look into it for you.
I'd appreciate that. This is my address.
Fine.
Drive safely. Seatbelt.
That's the guy who did it.
How do you know?
He looks like, that actor.
What actor?
Oh, well, you know how in Barnaby Jones you can always tell the bad guy because it's played by that actor that you see a lot?
Yes.
He looks like that actor. Trust me, they've never been able to fool me once. Or maybe he did it.
Ray, what's a come on? This is it.
See you later. Oh,
would you mind dropping by my place and checking on Deef? He's been in the apartment all day.
Oh, great. I can't wait to see what I'll find.
Thanks, Ray.
You owe me one.
All right. Afternoon, gentlemen.
They tell me he's feeling much better, thank you. I get to take them to the park today.
I understand there's going to be a hearing.
Yes, but everything is going to be okay. I'm going to win and keep my children.
I'm sure you will. I admire your spirit. You know, there's a story I keep forgetting to tell Mario.
I'm sure he will have liked it.
I learned it when I was a little boy. About an Inuit warrior named Nakuk, who became... terrified of another warrior from a neighboring village. So terrified that he decided to abandon his home and run. And every night he would build a small hut to stay in. But each of these one-night homes was weak, and he didn't have the time to make them strong. And so when his enemy finally found him,
Echo had nothing to protect himself, and he was lost.
That's a sad story.
Yes, it is.
How did you know?
Your family pictures are gone. You can't run, Margarita.
I'm so scared they're going to keep my children. I was going to take them.
I told you, I will help you.
I can't wait forever to have them back. I just can't.
Justice will out. I promise you.
Don't even think about it, okay? Don't even think about it, all right? Just do what you gotta do so I can get out of here, okay? You know why you can't go, don't you? It's all that sugar. Remember that the next time you try to eat something of mine. This is what happens to bad wolves. Come on, think results here. Go, will you? Never mind. Come on, we gotta go see somebody. Come on, we gotta go see somebody. Get a car. Move on.
Leave me alone.
Look, I just came to apologize. I should have never said you were nuts. You obviously do this for a very good reason, and you probably make a pretty good living at it, too.
You're not thinking of going into this yourself?
You mean scooping? I have no immediate plans.
An excellent living.
Really?
I collect it and sell it for fertilizer.
So you must really know your...
Like nobody else.
So where do you find it all?
Stables, pony rides. But they're not my biggest source.
Meatpacking plants.
The mother load.
Let me ask you a question. Have you noticed any subtle differences in the product at any of these various plants?
I'll check my database.
Great. Here's my card. Give me a call. And to show my appreciation, I'm going to point out that you missed something really nice behind that bucket there.
Why, thank you.
Thank you. You came all the way here to tell me that?
No. I got the information that you asked for.
Ah. Do you want to come up? No. I'll be right down.
Just in the neighborhood?
More or less. I go for a ride every morning.
Are these yours?
Yeah, getting quite a collection. Most of them I find homes for, but some are harder to give up than others.
You said you had some information for me.
Yeah, I did. Six major meat packers have had a pretty consistent purchase rate over the last several months.
Well, they're bringing in wild horses and being very quiet about it.
Wild horses?
I think they're stealing them from protected ranges.
Why would someone take a risk like that?
Thousands of pounds of free horse meat at $2 a pound.
Someone's making a fortune.
Exactly. Do you come here often? No, I didn't mean it to sound like that. What I meant was it's an unusual place. Well, not that there's anything wrong with that.
It's based on the second light.
Off in 30 seconds. Let's go. Okay, let's do this your way. Old Zalib came through for us. He remembers detecting some very subtle changes in a horseman rider particular plant. Do you want to hear which one? Do the words Barnaby Jones mean anything to you?
5, 4, 3.
No matter what you say, you cannot base an investigation on a theory developed from the casting of a television series.
You're just mad because I was right.
No, I'm not mad. It just doesn't make any sense.
Oh, and putting horse meat on your nose does?
Well, that was different.
You're telling me.
Boy, let me tell you, it doesn't get any better than this. Sitting in a car with Captain Hook watching ill-fated horses swap flies off their back.
Thank you very much.
They just passed inspection. No wild horses.
Hey, my source can look at palomino dung and tell you where they've been born, all right? He wouldn't be wrong about something like this. They'll be here. You just keep your eyes open.
Ray.
Oh, what?
Those are wild horses. They're brought in uninspected. Their meat is mixed with a little beef, then packaged and shipped off to cooperating supermarkets.
But some of the horses are diseased.
Can we get backup?
On a dog food case?
Then we'll have to do it ourselves.
Do what by ourselves?
Thief, stay.
Where are you going? Get sucked right out with it.
Evening.
Hold it!
Better run.
Hey, come on! Yeah, what was I so worried about?
Yeah, come on, let's go, come on!
Come on! Come on.
Go, guys, let's go!
Just did.
it's a dry cold.
How many do you think are still out there?
I'd say all 30.
Man, what are they waiting for?
Well, a mob can't change directions without a leader, Ray. If he was here, they would have acted already.
Ah, the hell with it. We're breaking out of here.
No, I don't think that's... Ray, that door is galvanized steel, and I just...
We're dead, right?
Not yet. We've been in here 19 and a half minutes. The temperature is sub-zero and dropping rapidly. I'd say we have roughly 37 minutes.
Oh, great. I'll just relax, because I'm sure it'll come shoot us before then.
You know, Ray, the Inuit would have ways of dealing with extreme conditions. Ruling out cannibalism, we have two options.
Can't wait to hear this.
The first is close body contact. We hug each other tightly, exchanging body heat. That should give us 10 minutes.
So what's the second? Some people die in their sleep. Others die making love to a beautiful woman. I am gonna die wrapped in meat.
Don't talk, Ray. You're expending body heat.
I'm gonna freeze to death inside my friend Flicka. Fraser?
Yes, Ray. Uh-oh.
This better be real important.
We got a cop and a Mountie in the freezer.
Hey, that's what I love about the meat business. Bring something new every day. What are you doing here, Pettit?
He's refusing to pick up the shipment.
I have a chain of stores to worry about. I don't need this.
Uh-huh.
But everybody needs a barrel of cash, don't they, Noah?
How long have they been in there?
Over an hour and a half.
Oh, they're dead. Shoot them anyway and get them out of here. You got a problem, Noah?
Sick kids, dead Mounties. Yeah, I'd say I got a problem.
You want out, Norm?
Yeah.
Well, why not? Plenty more supermarkets out there.
Thanks, Vince.
You got it. I do love this business. Give him and those copsicles a ride on the conveyor. And how about doing some work around here?
Come on, let's go.
Come on.
Come on, give me a hand.
God. I have this dream about dying wrapped in frozen meat.
Shoot him!
Couldn't penetrate the frozen meat. Come on.
You used me as a human shield.
I can't believe you did that. Quiet. Come on. Hey! Sorry.
Get this thing off me!
You should be nicer to animals. Well, that's the last of it.
Let me take it.
No. I've got it.
I want to thank you again for making this possible.
It was no trouble.
And I really want to thank him for everything he has done. In fact, I want to give him a big hug, but I'm afraid I will wrinkle him.
I know what you mean.
All right, I put the photographs on the mantle. Nice job. Now, don't forget,
it's $125 beginning of the month.
Didn't you say $375?
Yeah, well, I was adding on for utilities and...
Oh, I thought you said that the utilities were included.
Yeah. I had to rent to a Mountie. Bye.
I am sorry, I just can't help myself. Oh. Thank you. Thank you for my children.
No. You don't have to thank me.
He used you as a human shield?
Yeah, and there was just 2 inches of frozen pinto between me and a bullet.
Wow. Then what happened?
Ray, we have to get that trailer back.
I only wish I could hear more about your adventures as a police officer.
Well, I'd like that, too. Good luck with your new apartment, Mrs. Gomez.
Thank you.
And Mario, you stay in school.
Thanks. I think you really made his day.
It's okay. He actually was interesting.
Really? Well, goodbye.
I'm going riding tomorrow morning. You up for it?
You mean to discuss your testimony?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd love to.
Good.
Goodbye.
I still can't believe you did that.
It was perfectly safe, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, you practiced it on your past partner, Billy Swiss Cheese McAllister.
Well, granted, it was an unusual tactic, but I got the notion from a young cadet who lashed a caribou to his chest. Unfortunately, it was unrelated to police work.
Directions on this map, but you're only going one way.